Hey, Hope. Hey, it looks like we'll be having some classes together.
Yeah.
Yeah. Listen, I never had the chance to tell you how sorry I am about your sister. It's so strange to see you without her. You two were like twins.
I'm really...
Look, Hope, anything you need, you just ask, okay?
Oh, I promise. I can't believe that Michael McKenzie is coming to this school.
Well, I guess they're letting anybody in now. How did a guy like that get the money for tuition?
Didn't you read the student bulletin?
Uh-uh.
They're giving him a scholarship. Apparently the guy's some sort of genius or something.
Oh, really? A genius of what? Drinking? Somebody should convince him to transfer.
Well, it gets worse. Apparently he's in pre-law like us.
No.
Did you know that, Hope?
Yeah,
are those beans leftovers from last semester?
I don't know. You know what, those cookies don't look like they've ever killed anybody.
Well, be careful. You know what they say about the freshman 15.
Freshman 15?
Well, they say that the pressure makes you eat like crazy and you gain 15 pounds just like that.
Do I look fat to you?
Look, don't get so defensive. I didn't make it up. It's the pressure. Then I guess Michael McKenzie should gain a ton of weight.
I'd hate to be that guy on this campus.
But guys, just leave it alone, okay?
Look, just like he shouldn't be here, he does not belong. Maybe we should form a little unwelcoming committee for him.
Hey!
You too.
Great, what position?
Excuse me. Hope, can I talk to you? Please, just for a minute.
You know, we don't have anything to talk about, okay?
Well, I think that we do.
No, we don't.
Hey.
You heard her. The lady doesn't want to talk to you.
Look, just please. This is none of your business, so stay out of it, okay?
Hope. I'm making it my business.
Yeah, me too, man.
Okay, whatever. Don't even think that this is over, okay?
Thank you, guys. Bye. And thank you. All right.
Buddy, if I stay around any longer, they're gonna start charging me for tuition.
Yeah, okay.
Ooh, what time is it? All right, I gotta go call my mom, see if she needs a ride home.
Yeah, this one.
So, I'll be back in a couple minutes.
You got it.
Hey! You know you're not wanted here. We kind of like to keep up the school image.
Murderers aren't welcome here.
You don't belong in any university. You belong in a prison.
Look, you guys, I'm not looking for trouble, so there's really no need to start something, okay?
Well, we were trying to finish something. Look, we want you gone. We don't want to see you now, and we don't want to see you at soccer practice.
Take your presidential scholarship and shove it.
We don't care how much of a hot dog you are on the soccer field. We don't want you around.
Why don't you go back to your own neighborhood? Stay out of ours.
You know what? I think I'll do that.
I don't think so. Don't you think it would have been better if you would have killed your own mother?
What happened, man?
Dude,
what happened?
Just go, man.
Go. What's up?
You broke my nose!
Wait.
What'd you do, man? Did you get in a fight?
A
little squabble.
You did?
What, did you pull a Tyson, man, without me?
A little bit. Yeah, where the hell were you, man?
Yeah, I called my mom, man. She needed a ride home, dude. I'm always late, dude. I always miss stuff.
Yes, you do, man. I could have used you back there, although I must say I fared pretty well on my own.
Did you throw a couple knucklers?
You know what? Threw a couple knucklers. Nothing too serious.
They didn't come after you again, bro.
Yeah, well, maybe this time they'll know I'm not going to back down again, huh?
Dude, man, I'm going to be there next time. Let's get out of here.
Oh, yeah, let's go.
That'll hold you for now, but I'm afraid it's broken.
What?
Yeah, you better have a doctor take a look at it.
Rich, what happened to your nose? Don't tell me one of you guys did this.
Oh, God, those guys, no way.
Well, then who hit you?
Look, the guy who assassinated Hope,
He's a menace. He went nuts and attacked me.
And you guys didn't help him?
Yeah, we...
Look, he sucker punched me.
Do you have a way to get to the doctor?
I know.
I can take him.
Great.
How embarrassing.
Come on, keep your head up.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. I've been looking everywhere for you.
What?
Did you hear about what happened?
No, what?
There was a big fight, and guess who started it?
Who?
Your hunky friend, the one you didn't want to talk to.
Michael?
Yes, Michael.
Oh, what happened to him?
Nothing happened to him, but Rich got his nose broken, and Phil and Jimmy got their butts kicked.
What?
Can you believe it? They must have pushed him a little too far.
This wasn't about me, was it?
Well, if it was, you should be flattered.
What? How did this start?
I have no idea how it started. All I know was that when it was over, Rich was getting his poor little nose patched up at the nurse's.
Oh, my God.
They've been asking for it. They decided to push somebody around, and this somebody pushed back.
Yeah. You don't think he could get in trouble for this? I mean, he could lose his scholarship for fighting.
You know, I wouldn't be too worried about it. Somehow I don't see the three of them going to the dean and telling him that Michael beat them all up. Although, I would be worried about him on the soccer field, because they're bound to go after him there. And they start practice today.
Oh, I gotta see this. Come on.
Now, let's go.
How could you stand sitting next to that lowlife?
That's why I wanted to give him my seat.
You think the guy was gonna bite her the way you guys were acting?
The guy's dangerous. Look at my nose.
He did that to you?
Yeah, he busted it pretty good, huh?
Rich, you asked for it. You were looking for trouble.
How did this happen?
The guy is a criminal.
Yeah.
He's got criminal instincts and all that experience from being in jail.
Well, then stay away from him.
Hey, we're just doing it for you.
Well, don't.
Are you defending him?
No, I'm just looking out for you guys. I don't want him ganging up on the three of you.
Look, the guy sucker punched me, okay?
Yeah, I'd say he punched the sucker, all right. Listen, face it, you guys. You picked on the wrong guy.
I don't need your help, okay? Leave him alone.
You got something going with the guy? Yeah, you looked pretty upset when he got hurt at the soccer tryout.
Uh-huh. I'm Rich, I'd pick on somebody smaller than you.
This isn't over. Yeah, you can count on it.
Oh, you guys are such jerks.
I would think you'd hate Michael McKenzie.
I do.
Then why'd you defend him?
Look, the guy's not like us. He's an opportunist. He conned his way into that scholarship, and now we have to put up with him?
No, Rich. He earned it, and you can't take it away from him just because he broke your nose.
How can you defend the guy?
Just leave him alone!
Well, you guys really know how to piss somebody off.
What did we do now? I don't understand women.
Yeah, what's up with Hope?
She's gotta have a thing for Michael McKenzie. What did she tell you about him?
Don't ask me. If you want to know, you ask her. Oh,
so you're saying there is something?
I'm not saying anything. I am saying if you're smart, you'll never mention Michael McKenzie's name to her again.
That's it for today's lesson. In regards to our field trip on Sunday, you guys have a choice. We can either carpool or we can rent a bus. You decide.
A bus? I think we'll take our car.
Okay. So raise your hands if you have a car. Okay. How about we raise our hands if we need a ride? And you are?
I'm Michael McKenzie.
All right, Michael. You can ride with me.
Ooh, just don't let him drive.
All right. We'll meet at 7 a.m. in front of the administration building Sunday morning. Don't be late. We'll caravan from there, okay? All right.
What does your father think about us taking up on his development project?
What do you mean?
Well, the wetland development is your father's company. I thought he might not be too keen on us stirring up more controversy.
I'm sure my dad thinks the project's going to be great for the community.
Yeah, and maybe good for his pocketbook too, huh?
This is something he believes in, money.
Well, the project has gotten a lot of heat from the media.
Yeah, so I've heard.
Let's make him feel really uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Why don't you just leave him alone? He's just a student. Give him a break, Rich.
Yeah. Which leg?
Rich.
We understand you're still in shock over what happened to your sister, but...
Yeah. Seeing the guy that did it must really be hard for you.
Like, it's the prof. Hi.
Guys.
Hi. Hey.
Working hard, I see. May I join you?
Oh, yeah, please, sit down.
God, that bastard's so lucky.
Yeah. Oh. Oh.
Hey, Danny, how you doing,
buddy? All right, how about you?
Not too bad.
Yeah, I understand you're throwing quite a party tonight.
Yeah, well, my dad's having a birthday party. He's having a few people over.
Hey, his birthday. Well, tell him I send my best, will you?
Will do. Will do. Listen, do you know anything about those students asking a bunch of questions out there?
I haven't a clue. All they do when they come in here is buy soft drinks and candy bars.
Yeah, I don't know. It seems to me they're trying to stir up a bunch of trouble or something.
Yeah, as long as they buy stuff, they stir up all the trouble they want.
Yeah, business first, right, Danny?
That's right.
Hey, listen, I think I'm going to be getting lucky tonight. How about some safe sex items?
All right, okay.
All right.
Just a thing here for you.
Cool, great. Two's plenty. I think you give me too much credit sometimes.
Yes.
Hey, listen, Danny, do me a favor. If you find anything out about the students, why don't you give me a call at the house, all right?
Will do, Ray.
Okay. See you later.
All right, take care.
Thanks. Why?
My husband's been working in that factory for 25 years. He'll be without a job. That's why.
Can we ask you a few
more questions? No.
Take
the lead?
Swell, thanks.
Anytime.
Follow me.
Excuse me, sir. Do you mind if we ask you a few questions?
No.
We just had a few questions for a survey. It won't take very much time.
What do you want to know?
Well, we're curious to know how you feel about the proposed development.
Pine Woods. Can't wait till they finish it. More people means more business, and more business means more money.
But what about the wildlife that uses the wetlands?
I never had a duck come in here and buy anything. And the day that starts happening, I'll start caring.
You may change your mind when there aren't any.
I doubt it. Can I speak with Carl O'Donnell, please? Carl. Hi. Listen, I found out what these college kids are up to. Yeah.
Look, you don't have to threaten those kids. I want to nip this in the bud, Colin. I don't want this stuff to leak to the press, because if it does, we're in trouble. I'm going to tell you that.
What if the mayor gets cold feet?
The mayor's not going to get cold feet. The mayor's a businessman just like you and I. You keep this nice and low, this guy's going to stay in it, believe me. What I want to do, I want to introduce you to him. Put on the old Colin job. Schmooze him a little bit. It's going to be all right. Don't worry about it.
We can still use your crew.
How?
How? The kids are still running around town asking opinions, right? Why not make sure they get the right opinions? Flood the town with your crew with pro-Collinwood opinions. Nobody gets hurt. We get what we want. Good, huh?
You thought about that all yourself, huh?
It's good, huh?
It's terrific.
Isn't it good?
Sorry, everybody. Hail in a taxi. Tobias, come here, will you?
Hey, guys. Thanks for your help.
Thanks.
Yeah, we appreciate it.
Thank you.
Well, now what? What do you got?
Well, we got three stuff.
How's it going?
Great.
Goody, look who showed up.
We got plenty of opinions.
Just about everybody we talked to had something to say about Collinwoods.
I know what you mean. I got a lot of life stories.
Well, that's only going to help you understand the demographics better. Once you know what a person's background is, you can understand their opinions.
And we certainly had our share of the pros and cons, didn't we?
Yeah. Usually the truth is going to fall somewhere in the middle. You have to look at the responses on the extreme ends of the spectrum and just throw them out. Look at what falls right in the middle.
The mayor would love to know the results of the survey you've been taking. He also
always has an ear for public opinion.
Well, we haven't really finished analyzing and tabulating the results.
Well, he'd still like to get a little bit of feedback. Plus, it's a great party. You'll have a lot of fun.
Listen, why don't you go ahead? Alice and I can finish up. It's not every day the mayor asks to see you.
Yeah, don't miss out on a party because of us. We'll be okay.
I'm sorry. I can't leave my students.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Why don't we all come then?
Yeah.
Hey.
All right.
Let's go.
You can do that.
All right.
Check that out.
Didn't
smile.
Take that out. Such a minute.
Yeah,
money here.
Oh, God.
Wow. Do you know whose place this is?
Why? What's wrong?
Nothing.
I'm assuming that it's the mayor's.
Yeah.
Rich, do you know, is this the mayor's place?
I don't know, but I can find out.
Okay. All right. Hey, why don't we sit down? Yeah, maybe they'll feed us.
That's a good idea.
Maybe they'll stop looking at us.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go. Oh, God.
I love it. Uh-oh. That's Hope's father over there.
What? The architect? Colin Cornell. The guy who developed Collinwoods.
Yeah.
They should have connected the names.
Professor, this is some party, huh?
Yeah. Some party.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear friend. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, everybody. Enjoy your night. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming.
Mr. Cornell, you look beautiful. I
Rich!
Just came by to say hi.
Hi, man. How are you, son? Boy, it's good to see you. Hey, listen, everybody, let me introduce you here. This is the boy of a very, very good friend of mine, and is also a classmate of Hope's over at the university.
Hi, sir. How's Hope, by the way? We missed her on our film trip.
She's doing a lot better. Thank you very much. Hey, I want you to meet the host here. This man right here, this is Fred O'Donnell. He's 95 years old. Can you believe? Look at this man. He's holding up very well.
Good, kid.
Nice to meet you.
And this is Mayor Bob. This is Rich, Mayor.
It's a pleasure meeting you, Mr. Mayor. Richard. Thanks for inviting us to this great party.
How you been, man?
Carl, come here, will you?
Fantastic.
Hey, my dad wants to know.
See if these kids need anything, will you, buddy?
Oh, yeah, you got it.
Thanks a lot.
You know, I'll tell you what, I'll let him know. I'll give him a call.
Thanks.
All right. Hey, Rich, bye-bye. Say hello to your mom and dad for me, will you?
Hey, great.
Yeah, so you having a good time at the party or what?
Yeah. By the way, I'm Rich.
Rich, how you doing? I'm Carl O'Donnell. This is my dad's birthday party we're having here for him.
Cool, 95, huh?
Yeah, you know, Mr. O'Donnell there. Hey, listen, is there a Michael McKenzie in your group?
Yeah, there is one. Do you know?
Kind of. Hey, listen, I'm going to send a waiter over here for him. Make sure you tell him whatever you need, and you'll get it. I'll take care of you, all right?
All right.
I'll talk to you later, buddy.
See ya.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Okay.
Hey, we're being ignored.
I know.
Hey, here comes Rich.
Well, finally.
Hey. About time.
How are you?
Great. Hey, I know whose place this is.
So it's not the mayor's?
No, it belongs to a guy named O'Donnell. I guess he's partners with Hope's father. I was just talking to his son. I didn't know you knew him.
Know who?
Carl O'Donnell.
I don't know any Carl O'Donnell.
Well, he seems to know you. Hey, Prof,
you gotta tell the mayor thanks for inviting us.
I will.
All right.
Hey, whoever made this cake is the best cake I've ever had in my life.
Your Honor, the students are here. Do you want me to organize an impromptu press conference?
Sounds like a good idea to me.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am. Jennifer.
Certainly.
Aren't we pushing our luck a little bit here? You don't know what those kids are gonna say now, do you?
I think I've got things pretty much under control, Mr. Cornell. I'm a public relations person. This is what I do.
Yes, I know, but if you make a mistake, you're going to make things a lot worse than they already are. And do you really want to take that chance?
I'm doing my job.
You know, as usual, Jennifer, you don't get the big picture. You never get the big picture. Why is that, Jennifer?
You have no right to talk to me that way. I don't work for you anymore.
No, you don't. You work for my partner. But this is my project. You mess this up for me, it won't make a damn bit of difference who you work for, Jennifer.
I'm doing...
Do not screw around with me, kid. I'm way out of your league. You hearing that?
I'm doing my job.
If one of those kids makes some detrimental comment to the mayor and messes up my deal, I'm gonna have your head on a stake.
I just feel responsible for bringing you here in the first place.
What? It's not your fault. You had no idea that...
Mr. Cornell is going to be here.
Hey, I'm sorry about that golf game last week. I'll take it easy on you next time, okay?
Okay, buddy.
Jennifer. Let's go see the group.
Wait.
Oh, we having fun or what? Good food and good booze.
If these are the people behind the project, I'm on their side.
Well, no wonder some of the town folks were against it. They didn't get invited to this great party.
Hey, yeah. It's easy to be against people you don't know. Besides, everybody has an opinion.
Well, not everybody has a good one. And why does everybody have the right to have one anyway?
Well, some people give their opinions without knowledge of the facts at all.
That last crew we interviewed looked like working people, and they sure seemed to like the idea of the project.
Yeah, towards the end there, everybody seemed to be for it.
Rich, you having a good time, buddy?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Cornell.
Listen, the mayor would like to have a small press conference with you guys about Collinwoods. Mm-hmm. We'll give you an opportunity to ask him some questions.
Oh, well, sounds really good.
Now, Rich, introduce me to your friends here.
Well, okay, this is Phil.
Hi, Phil.
And we got Pat over here.
Hi, Phil.
And we got Jimmy.
Hi, Jimmy.
We got Hilda over here.
Honey, how are you?
Nice to meet
you.
And
we got Kelly on the
Kelly,
hi.
Welcome to the party.
Hi,
thank you.
Very nice to meet
you. These are my friends.
Thank you.
Mr. Cornell, you haven't met the rest of our group.
Introduce me. Excuse me.
I would like you to meet the Professor Fields.
Hi.
Hi, please, Edith.
Edith, hi, how are you?
This it's is
nice
Mike.
To meet you. Mike. Alice. Edith, the mayor is setting up a little round table question and answer session. We thought it'd be a nice idea for you and the students want to have a face-to-face talk with him.
It's great if you do arrange that. It sounds like a wonderful idea.
I knew you'd like it.
Excuse me. Would everybody please settle down? We're about to begin.
Ah, thank you. Thank you for coming, folks. Hello, I'm Colin Cornell. And this is my partner, Fred O'Donnell. And as you all know, our guest of honor, Mayor White. Let's give him a hand. Fred and I, we're the developers of Collinwoods, and we're here to answer any of your questions about the project you care to ask. So, fire away. Who's first?
Come on, guys, speak up.
Some of the people we talked to, we're worried about your project having an adverse effect on the old town traditions.
What's your name, son?
Phil.
Phil, progress costs, change is inevitable. You won't be able to stop the future no matter how long or how hard you drag your feet. Now, I can assure you that Collinwoods will be developed as a friend, not as a foe. I mean, we've checked out the landscaping, and this project will be built with the environment in mind, not against it. All right?
Well, we heard some talk of a factory on adjoining land being closed down. Is there any truth
in
that?
You know, I think, Mayor, you ought to answer that question. That's right up your alley.
Thank you, Colin. That's something that's being considered, but it hasn't happened yet. It's a perfect example of what Mr. Cornell's talking about. The factory is a blight on the environment, and losing it will be a step in the right direction, ecologically speaking.
Won't that cost jobs for the people who work there?
You should think of it more as a redistribution of jobs. A polluting factory will be moved to a more appropriate location. The resulting rezoning will open up the area for housing, which will attract more people to the area, more people, more income, higher tax base, more jobs. All of that in addition to the jobs created by the initial construction.
Well, Your Honor, not everybody here wants to see that kind of growth.
Our national population is exploding. Growth is a fact, not an option.
Yeah, but sir, what are you going to say to the people who want to see things stay just as they are?
I can answer that, Mayor. Want me to take it on? Rich, society is an evolution of change. I mean, read about what happened to the dinosaurs. It's unavoidable, right?
Well, this is the place. If you just go through those double doors and find the mayor.
Aren't you coming?
No. I get enough of Collinwoods at home. I actually prefer the party to the propaganda.
I think I know what you mean. Well, I hope to see you again.
I would like that.
This project will give a big boost to our sagging economy, and jobs is an issue that we can't afford to ignore right now.
Your Honor, with all due respect, can we afford to ignore the environment? Can we afford to ignore what the impact Colin Woods is going to have on our wetlands?
What's this jerk bastard doing in my party?
Alan, you know, I've had experts from all over the state come in and check on the impact of this project, and they don't see a problem at all.
No, I guess not, if you're not a duck or a heron or any other wildlife that needs that wetlands. No problem if you don't mind wiping out a species.
For Christ's sake, she is wearing his ring. So I'm sorry, I'm out of here. Excuse me.
Michael, please. Michael.
You know, Alan, I mean, I could show you after...
Oh, my God.
Help
everybody,
me out here.
Please, would everybody clear the room? So please give her air, please.
Please, everybody please leave. We need
to... Would everybody okay. please leave?
She needs air. Come on.
Do what Jennifer please says. Go, we really go, don't need go. Anybody in the room here please. So we can get some air for my daughter.
Poor Hope, she looked terrible. You really think she'll be okay?
How should I know? I'm not a doctor.
Dude, I wonder what made her faint like that.
Well, maybe she really was sick.
What happened in there?
Hope Cornell fainted.
Oh, my goodness. Is she gonna be all right?
Yeah, she's just been pushing herself too hard. She should have been at home in bed, not at a party.
Speaking of parties, where is Michael and the professor?
Oh, that's really funny, yeah. though.
You know, you just need a friend right now, and I think we should get out of here. They're not gonna miss us.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Hey, guys, I wonder if Hope's gonna show up for class.
No way. Not after passing out at the party like that.
You suppose that was it? You think she was blitzed?
Oh, come on, bro.
Oh, come on. Hope doesn't seem like the type to be much of a drinker.
Well, maybe she's one of those closet boozers, the type who gets hammered when nobody's around.
Or maybe I'm the Easter Bunny. Look, Hope's not that kind of girl.
Hey, anybody can have a problem, you know?
She hit her head and she had a relapse. That's all. Leave it to you guys to make a big deal out of nothing.
Speaking of nothings, look who's here.
Aren't those the same clothes he was wearing yesterday?
Maybe he can't afford clothes.
Or maybe he didn't go home last night. You don't think he and the professor...
They did disappear from the party at the same time.
All right, everybody, let's settle. You could get out your textbooks. Chapter 12, page...
You draw your own conclusions. Put it down on paper.
Okay. Should we include opinions given by Colin Cornell and the mayor?
It's up to you to decide what's important and what's not.
Well, too bad we didn't get a chance to ask him all the questions we wanted to.
Why didn't you?
Oh, yeah. You left early before all the excitement.
What excitement?
Well, Hope Cornell fainted and they had to clear the room.
Yeah, we didn't get to finish the conference.
Hope fainted?
Yeah.
What brought that on?
She was probably drunk.
Yes, dude, you wanna go-
Guys, sit down!
Gentlemen, you seem to be under the misconception that we are running some sort of a training camp for the pugilistic arts here and not a university.
He started. I didn't do anything.
Yeah, Phil's telling you the truth. He was just sitting in his seat.
Look, Michael attacked him.
You want to see
Michael,
that?
Man. Michael.
He's not one of us. The guy's a total Neanderthal.
Professor,
please. So the three of you would agree that Mr. McKenzie is guilty of assault with no extenuating circumstances?
Raymond, a comment was made about Hope Cornell. That's what started all the trouble.
And would you consider this comment in any way provocative?
Hmm?
I see. Gentlemen, it would seem as more evidence comes into play here, you seem to have perjured yourselves. This does not bode well for your position. I would suggest that you drop all charges and walk away before you find yourselves on the losing side of your very first case. Now, is this a course of action you would care to pursue?
Yeah.
Fine. Then we will consider this matter closed, and I would suggest, I would strongly suggest, that you leave it that way. And you had better learn to control your temper. Thank you, gentlemen.
Man, Michael McKenzie gets away with murder.
Literally, that maniac always comes out on top. He's got Ginsburg in his back pocket.
Dude, you got something to say to me? Why don't you say it to my face? I didn't think so.
Hey, look, we don't want any trouble, okay?
Yeah, unlike you, McKenzie, we can't afford it.
Well, if you guys want to stay out of trouble, then why don't you stay the hell out of my way?
Oh, we'll be happy to. We don't want any trouble with your teacher friends.
What do you mean, my teacher friends?
Oh, come on, Michael. Like, you and Ginsburg aren't pals.
And you and Edith aren't bumping uglies,
huh? What the hell are you talking about, huh?
Come on, McKenzie, you think we're stupid? You took off from the party with the old prof, and today you show up wearing the same clothes. My guess is you're gonna get an A in sociology.
Yeah, I heard she fainted. What do you guys know about it?
Well, if you really want to know, McKenzie, right after you left, she got really pale. And when she tried to stand up, she passed out.
That's all we know, McKenzie. They cleared the room afterwards.
Fine, I gotta go call her.
Wait, McKenzie, maybe you should call O'Donnell's ranch, because that's where Hope spent the night. Maybe she just wanted an excuse to stay at her new boyfriend's house.
Dude, you wanna go?
Dude, look, don't get pissed at me. You asked, I told.
You seem to enjoy yourself a little too much.
Why does he care? He got the sociology professor.
Yeah, she's a real catch. He gets good looks and good grades at the same time.
Dude, I think lover boys should line up because, hey, I'm jealous. Dude, let's go.
Hey, McKenzie, your old pal Ginsburg is paging you. He wants you back in his office.
Yeah, maybe he wants to give you another scholarship.
Hey, guys, you think McKenzie's porking your old professor?
Well, he sure isn't our old professor. And I wish I was as lucky as he is. Man, he looks like a fox.
That's an understatement.
What I'd give to get into her pants. Man, he had all last night to do it. I wish I could have watched.
I wish I had pictures.
Hey, guys, maybe she minor in sex therapy, huh?
Shut up! Woo!
Well, I believe Michael. I think he's innocent. They never took him to court and tried him and proved he was guilty. And in this country, you are innocent until proven guilty.
I know, but they tried him in the media, and they found him guilty as charged. Your average guy on the street thinks he did it.
Well, I know him, and I don't. Michael is a wonderful, sensitive person.
Okay, Madruga. Dios le ayuda, which means the one who gets up early, God will help. So what do you think that is in English? Give up? The early bird catches the worm.
Ah, of course.
Just a little group here? See if you can translate this.
We can take care of this later. I have a free period in 40 minutes, and we can talk in my office.
Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Do you have an office now? You have a job? Tell me something. When did you start to take...
Hey, no, Michael,
shut up! Somebody call security.
When did you start that?
Okay, when our forefathers formed the Constitution, they had a very specific idea of justice in their mind. But everyone stay put.
I'm going to listen to everything I say. I don't want to cry from you. You understand me? You understand me?
Please, this is where I work. Please.
Work! You know what your work is? To stay with me, wash my socks. That's what your work is.
What the hell's wrong with you right now, man? What, did you understand? Leave the lady alone.
Hey, take it easy.
You're not gonna shoot
me. Want to press your luck a little bit?
You're the one taking your luck here, friend.
Is that right? Let me tell you something. This is my wife, and I'm taking her out of here. You understand me?
No, friend. You hurt anybody here, and I will prosecute you so fast.
Oh, is that right? Take a walk, Ginsburg.
I'm all right. Nothing's gonna happen to me.
Oh, nothing's gonna happen to you. When I get you home, I'm gonna knock you out. That's what's gonna happen.
Oh, I've had it with you, friend.
Professor, Dean Chandler's office, please. It's an emergency.
All right, man. Nicely done, Prof. You stay on, Chief. I'm gonna try it, man.
You haven't seen the last of me, Ginsburg. I can guarantee you that. I can guarantee you.
Well, you know where to find me.
I'll be back.
Mm-hmm. What's going on here?
Nothing. Just an overage punk with a big mouth. Now, the excitement's over. Everybody back in class. Oh, man, I thought the security guards would never show up. Are they taking a permanent coffee break?
Nancy, are you okay? Yeah? You gonna be okay?
Okay.
Yeah?
You know who I am? You know who I am when I get through with you. Both of you, either one of you, you won't be able to get a doghouse, you idiots.
Did you see that?
What a jerk.
Poor thing. No wonder she left him. That man is a monster. No wonder Carl turned out the way he did.
How could she ever have married someone like that?
Well, we all make mistakes.
Oh, that guy is some mistake. What an incredible jerk.
Who does he think he is?
Imagine if he does this in public. What do you think he does in private?
Well, Mike, that guy didn't seem to like you very much.
Well, I'm not too choked up about him either, you know?
Well, there's something we all agree on.
Yeah.
How Ginsburg punched that guy?
Well, not too bad for a professor.
He sure decked him, huh?
Well, the guy never saw it coming.
What do you think, Mackenzie?
I think we should start calling the professor Sugar Ray Ginsburg.
Sugar Ray Ginsburg. What does that mean?
Hey.
Hi.
Hey,
is Nancy okay?
Yeah, she's gonna be all right. She's just really embarrassed.
Yeah?
If I really humiliated her.
Well, he really scared me. I'm sure that shook her up some.
Well, Ginsburg took care of him.
I didn't expect him to do that. I mean, the guy had a gun. Come on. That was very brave of Ginsburg, I gotta admit.
Yeah, it really was. So, what are you gonna wear to the dance?
What dance?
Oh, come on, Hope. Are we talking the same language? The big dance after the big game.
Yeah,
the one your honey Michael's gonna lead us to victory in, you know?
Oh, that dance. You know, I don't think I'm gonna be going. What? I thought I was sort of broken.
No, that kind of upset can affect his performance.
He could blow the big game.
Yeah.
Guys.
Here, Alice. It's for you.
Hey, guys. We're in trouble. Look, guys, we gotta do something. Michael's not gonna be able to think about the game if Hope's not there, and he's gonna be upset.
Well, what can we do?
He'll try and get the two of them back together.
Well, they love each other. They should be able to work things out. What happened with Jenna Mellis?
I don't know. She didn't tell me anything this time. I mean, last I heard, they were gonna get married, and now they're split up.
Well, that makes things even worse, doesn't it?
Look, if Hope's not at the game, Michael's gonna fall apart.
Yeah, he's gonna be 100%, or we're gonna get our butts kicked.
That's for sure.
Alice, you gotta make sure Hope's at the game.
Okay, I will do what I can.
Well, do even better.
Yes.
Okay.
Please.
I'll get her there. If Michael wins the game, are you gonna give him a big kiss?
Stop. Well, if you don't, I will.
You guys, I'm sure everybody here in the stadium would love to give him a big wet one. But I really think Edith should be the one to do that. I'm sure Michael would like it.
Don't be silly, Hope.
Yeah, no. You're not serious about that, are you? Hey, why not? She likes him, he likes her. Why should I care?
Because you do.
What makes you so sure about that?
Because you're acting like a jealous kid. I'm just saying, Adam.
Well, she makes me so mad I want to spit on her.
Well, spit on her. It's been on Michael. It's not his fault if she has the hots for him.
Yes, it is.
Okay, stop, guys. We're starting again.
All right.
Come on, Michael!
Yeah, come on, Michael.
Okay, this is a moment of truth.
McKenzie, you better come through for us. He is a scholarship student, you know.
Oh, God, come on, Michael, you gotta win it. You gotta win it, come on.
Let's go. Okay, everybody, let's concentrate, send him good vibes. Okay.
Gimme.
Okay. Yeah? He's gonna do it.
Come on, baby, win it for me, win it for me!
Much, man. We beat those guys. So much for being the underdogs.
Hell yeah,
huh?
We are one hell of a team.
Huh?
Well, Michael, you're one hell of a player.
You were the one who did it, Michael.
No. Yeah. Don't give me all the credit. This was totally a team thing. Hey, McKenzie.
Yeah.
Great game.
Right on.
I think that I was worried about how you would play.
So, Hope, are your parents coming?
No, I don't know. You know, I didn't reserve them a table, so.
So what table are you sitting at, then?
Professor O'Donnell's.
Oh. Hey, Hope, I was wondering if you needed a ride tonight.
No, I don't. Actually, Carl's gonna pick me up, but thank you, Rich.
Where does he live?
Right nearby, don't worry about it.
All right.
Okay, I don't even know if I can go after what I did today. Oh, jeez.
Hope, you are going.
You have to go. You're gonna be queen, remember?
Queen horn dog.
Knock it off. Nobody's gonna remember what happened at the game.
Oh, I see. The entire university's developed Alzheimer's.
Great. It's the last time you're gonna see Michael, and it's the last time you're gonna see us.
Oh, I'll be there.
All right.
Okay.
See
bye.
See
ya. Bye.
Alice?
Yeah.
What kind of car does Carl drive?
Some sort of flashy red convertible.
Oh, yeah, I know the one. Yeah. Okay, you guys don't worry about a thing. I'll take care of it.
What are you gonna do?
Surprise, surprise.
Surprise, surprise.
Hi, guys.
Hey, what do you got there?
Ooh, man.
Oh, honey, you look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Okay.
Here we go. All right. Has Carl called?
No, he hasn't.
Oh, I can see you're really disturbed by this information.
Mm-hmm.
I think I should call. I wonder if anything's happened.
You know that it wasn't my fault.
Oh, don't I know that, honey. I understand that.
I mean, this whole thing was her idea, and I think it's a great idea, Colin.
Honey, you look spectacular.
Oh, you do? You look lovely.
Isn't she a knockout?
Yeah.
What is it with Carl? Why is he a little late?
Dad, I just called him. He's right on his way. Don't worry about it.
Well, if he didn't get here on time, I'll just have Armando.
No, Dad, don't do that. Please, don't do that. It's fine.
I I'll take you.
No, Dad, don't. See, that's Carl right now. He's calling from his car phone, I'm sure.
Hello?
Good evening, ma'am. Is Hope in?
Yes. Could I tell her who's calling?
It's Richard, one of Hope's friends from school.
It's your friend Richard?
Rich! Hello?
Hey, Hope. You know, Carl's having problems with his car, and he told me to pick you up.
And he'll catch up with you later.
I didn't know you knew Carl.
Oh, come on, Hope. I know everybody. I'm a popular guy.
Okay, great. Okay, I'll see you here. Bye.
What do you want?
Apparently, Carl's having car trouble, so he sent some of his friends to come and get me.
When's he gonna be here?
Any minute now, Dad. He called from his car phone.
I can't believe we just did that.
Screwing up that guy's car was fun, wasn't
it? Yeah, now Hope won't be showing up with Carl, huh?
Well, we're not pranksters. We're
love connectors.
Look, Dad, that's them right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and go. I'll
Vanessa,
see you guys
bring those kids in here. I wanna meet them.
Yes, sir.
Whoa. Oh. Hello.
Hi, is Hope in?
Yes,
correct. Hey. Oh, Hope, you look beautiful. This turned out better than I thought.
Oh, my God. How are you, sir?
Hi, Rich. Rich, you want to introduce me to your friends?
Yeah, Jim and Phil.
Jim and Phil, how you doing? Hey, listen, fellas, the 38 is in the drawer, the shovel's in the back, so make sure she gets there safe.
Well, don't worry. I'll take her home. Don't worry about anything. Let's get out of here.
All right, have a good time. Honey, you want to give your father a kiss? Thank you.
Bye,
all right. Have a good time, guys.
Bye, sweetheart. Your handbag's by the door. Okay. Bye.
Drive careful.
See you later, man.
Mm-hmm.
There goes your little girl.
I'm not good at this.
Hello? Yes, Nancy, we heard.
Oh. Hey, Hope.
Hey, Michael.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I didn't expect you to be here tonight.
Not upset you?
The truth? Yes. Yes, very much so, as a matter of fact.
I thought you were done with me for good.
I thought so, too. And then I had to face the prospect of never seeing you again.
Why are we doing this to each other?
Tell me.
Good evening, everybody. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our dance. Thank you for coming here tonight. And I'd like to present to you the dean of our university, Mr. John Chandler.
Thank you, and good evening to everyone, to all the parents, faculty, students, and their dates. Welcome, especially to the members of our victorious soccer team. But before we go any further, it is my privilege to introduce and announce the king and queen of our dance tonight, Hope Cornell and Michael McKenzie. The dance floor is now open, so please join the king and the queen.